chairs. Please, please
sound
be
like
careful,
a microphone yeah? from Lady so Gaga.
Du har helt sikkert hørt om Bosch tidligere og har kanskje et Bosch-produkt hjemme, men visste du at de så mye mer enn bare elektroverktøy og hvitevarer? De som et høyteknologisk powerhouse som i forkant av temaer som AI, smart mobilitet, helsetjenester og mye mer. Deres teknologier kan rett og slett bli funnet overalt. Tenk på din absolutt favorittbil. Yes, Bosch har mest sannsynlig teknologien i din bil. Det derfor vi her på Bosch Innovation Campus i Budapest. I denne serien skal jeg møte ingeniører som jobber hos Bosch, og jeg lurer rett og slett på hvordan det å jobbe her, hva de driver med og hvem de faktisk So let's go. Hi, nice to meet you.
Hi, I'm Chongor.
Nice to meet you. My name is Joachim. I denne episoden skal jeg møte Chongor, som en ekte bilentusiast og en seniorekspert innen electrical drivetrain development på Bosch, hvor han leder et stort innovasjonsteam med fokus på electrical drivetrain technology. Teamet hans sitt hovedfokus å forbedre disse systemene, samtidig som man bevarer på energien for å maksimere potensialet deres.
Yes.
Cool. So what is all of this?
So let me start at the beginning. So we are working on electrical drivetrain development.
Okay.
So we are developing the heart of the electrical cars.
Yeah.
And we have three main units.
Okay.
One is the power electronic unit.
Mm-hmm.
So from the battery, we are having a DC power, and that's what we are converting to AC power.
Mm.
AC power is necessary for the rotating magnetic field, which we have in the e-machine. But for moving the whole car, we need lower RPMs and higher torque, and that's what we fine-tuned with the transmission at the end.
Okay.
Once we design the drivetrain, you know, at the end we somehow should examine that we are, let's say, engineered it well.
Yeah.
So we have to measure it, right, somehow, because actually the audible noise of a drivetrain is really important for the end users. So we have
is this a microphone or
okay. Just grab it.
Cool.
Just please
sound like
careful,
a microphone from Lady Gaga.
Fancy. Yeah, it's fancy, and it's really fancy because here we have cameras.
Okay.
Which is detecting this motor, which is right now rotating.
Yeah.
And we have here a microphone and reference point. These are reference points. So the camera can know that where are you moving.
Oh, yeah, where the sound is coming from.
You can actually check this out.
Sorry.
See, the shape of the microphone occurred.
Yeah. Wow.
And the guys increasing the RPM, and you can sense the increased noise. If you are would like measuring Sweet. That surface, then you are just moving there the camera.
Jeg synes det så fascinerende at du kan faktisk tracke lyden på hvor den med bevegelighet. Det akkurat som lyd på en måte blir en gjenstand med all denne teknologien. Jeg synes det så kult.
So Joachim,
yeah.
So now we checked it in component level, that's how we are validating basically what we've done.
Mm.
But we also have to validate it in built-in condition. So we are stepping in a system level.
Yeah.
The system is now the car.
Okay.
We are implementing.
Are we going to go to a car now?
Exactly. Or,
yes, exactly. Okay, cool.
And we have a fancy room for that, similar to this one, but much larger.
Okay.
So it's huge.
Wow. Cool. So, I feel like I'm in Star Trek or something.
Yeah, close to that. So, Joachim, we would like to illustrate you
a
virtual street, which is ideal. So you cannot measure on the streets because there are so many disturbing things, you know, traffic and so on. But we would like to measure it, actually the car that way, that we would like to identify the sounds just from the car.
Yeah.
And all the surfaces here is same as on the streets, so it's reflecting, but walls basically isolated.
Yeah.
So it's an ideal street, a noiseless street.
I feel now when we're talking, it's weird.
It's some kind of pressure on your ear. Yeah.
Wow.
And
Matt here. Yeah, nice to meet you. Right. My name is Joachim.
Could you please show it to us? So actually we have an acoustic camera here. And Matt,
that's the camera there. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the acoustic camera has 56 microphones in there. Precisely those little dots in the arms and those spirals to locate the sound precisely where it comes from. And it also depends on pitch. So deep sounds and high sounds, and it can separate those so we can really see what comes where from the car and what is really something that's sticking out. So
I see when you're talking, it's now when I'm talking, it's making those colors on the screen.
Exactly. That's the hotspot.
Yeah.
So you are now the loudest officially.
But this may be a stupid question, but why do you guys have this camera and why is this a soundproof room?
So actually, as I mentioned, we would like to identify that which kinds of noises coming from the car.
Yeah.
And then we are filtering between those noises to identify which caused by the drivetrain.
Yeah.
And here Matej steps in because he's the expert at how we are testing automotive components from noise, vibration, and harshness point of view.
And that's why you guys have the camera, just to see where the sound comes from. Yeah.
Yes.
Herregud, det er så komplisert og veldig spennende. Should I sit in the car?
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
Men tenk, I de bitte små detaljene, så det så mye jobb.
As you can see, now we are speaking, you can see the windows flashing.
Yes.
On the camera.
When can you see if there's some problems with the technician in the car? You guys find it out here, right?
Exactly. Yeah. So we are basically putting in the drivetrain into a car.
Mm.
And after that, we have requirements that how low we should be and between certain conditions. So for example, in which speed we are rotating the wheels and which torque.
Mm.
So we are defining it as working points.
Okay.
And in those working points, do we exceed the limit or not or something like that? That's a specification which we are receiving from the car manufacturers. That what do they need?
Thank you so much for all this information. I feel much smarter already. But I'm going to meet now Anna. Is there a question I should ask her that you think is important?
I think it's a tricky one.
Yeah.
Which kind of semiconductor technology is the future in her eyes?
Oh,
so silicon carbide MOSFET or silicon IGBT?
Hmm. Okay. Da skal jeg prøve å huske dette spørsmålet. Jeg tror ikke jeg kommer til å klare det.
Hello? Hi there.
Hi. Yeah. Anna, nice
to meet you. Joachim, nice to meet you.
Anna har rundt 8 års erfaring som simuleringsingeniør og 4 år som ingeniørsjef hos Porsche. Hun bringer omfattende kompetanse til hennes rolle og spesialiserer seg på utvikling av kraftmoduler, den kritiske komponenten som kobler til batteripakken og elektrisk monitor I en inventor. Arbeidet hennes spennes over hele produktets livssyklus, fra det første konsept til serieproduksjon og utover.
So what are you working on?
So actually what I'm working on is a part of the electric drivetrain. I like to call it the heart.
Okay,
of the electric drivetrain.
Yeah. Is this the heart? No, what is the heart?
Yeah, this is it.
Okay.
It looks like a Game Boy. Sorry.
So they are responsible of transforming the current for the motor. So basically you have DC current, like tuck, tuck, tuck from the battery, and it has to be transformed into the three-phase alternating current for the motor to work.
Wow. Yeah. Why is this technology important for the future of technology?
Yeah, it is the key to electrification.
Mm.
This part here is a crucial part of the electric drivetrain. My job is actually to make sure that thermally everything works in this part. So we have here like high currents and high voltage, which is dangerous.
Mm.
And you have to take away from this high current area the heat to the water. We have water cooling, and this water cooling is directly attached to the car body, so basically you touch it. So we have to make sure that the high current from here doesn't go into the water on the bottom. And the big challenge in my work is actually that materials by nature that I isolating electrically are also isolating thermally, so they are not a good thermal conductor, they are insulators. And if I want a good connection to the cooling from the hot part, but also I want to isolate it electrically, that's a tricky thing. And I have to make sure that this happens correctly.
I feel like I touched the heart of a car. I want to like, no, I'm just kidding, around with it.
I'm not going to steal your baby. So those, that are the chips.
Mm-hmm.
So those are the semiconductors that switch the current, and the high current flows through this path, through these tiny wires.
Those tiny wires looks like blood veins. If it would be like a heart, this is like where the where it pumps all the blood.
Exactly.
Dette så komplisert. Jeg skjønner ikke at dette her går an en gang. Ja. Beauty and brain, I have to say. I'm super gay, so I'm not trying to flirt with you. Wow, really. And what is all this behind me here?
Yeah, let me show you what a chip really is. So it has 3 modules, and now we prepped it in a way so the 2 modules which are not painted black, we're going to light up. if I switch on the light, because the switch can act as a diode. And you know, LED, the light is also a diode. It's a light emitting diode. And it's the same in our chips. So if I will turn it on, they will light up.
Okay. Herregud, det her så fancy. Og bittesmå detaljer som har så mye å si.
And now you can see it.
Okay, wow, that's the blue thing there, right?
Yeah. So those are the chips. They act like an LED LED and they light up. Yeah, exactly.
Wow.
And now look on the camera, because this is actually an infrared camera, which is measuring how it heats up.
Yeah.
And now it's showing that it started around room temperature and now we're up to 90 degrees Celsius. So these chips are getting really hot as they are operating because they are conducting this current. And that is the most important part of my job, actually, to manage this high heat, which is getting conducted through the electrical current.
And so it's not overheating.
So get it away, the chips, so the chips don't overheat.
Yeah.
And for that, we use water cooling.
I have to say thank you so much for showing me all of this. And I will think about the heart of a car every time I'm sitting in an electric car. Wow.
Nice.
Hvis du likte denne videoen, så må du sjekke ut de to andre episodene vi har laget, som ligger på Bosch sin YouTube-kanal og på deres nettsider. Jeg utfordrer deg til å tenke neste gang du bruker smarttelefonen eller sitter i en bil, og tenke over hva slags Bosch-teknologi som i den. Så er det bare for meg å si på gjensyn, så ses vi i neste video.